3 attempts.
It was more than that. Of pressing on the wrong button, I think I'm live. Honestly, I'm not sure, but it's possible that I'm live. It's possible you hear me here in the microphone too. I mean, it's all possible. It's a bit like Schrodinger's stream. On one hand, he may be streaming, talking about building a ukulele. Yeah, that we've decorated after putting it together, and now we need to add the finishing touches, like bits. And on the other hand, maybe he's not streaming. Maybe nobody knows what's going on, and nobody's there. That is also a possibility. So, there's a bit of commotion going on. It's because the artist is in the room, and the artist is not me. But as you can see, the ukulele that we put together yesterday with glue for leather, by the way, big mistake. Probably use glue for wood if it's wooden. Has been decorated, as you can see, professionally. Now, I must admit, the artist that you can hear right now did not come up with the whole design. I did trace the black lines, and then she had to fill in the bits that were created by the meeting and the sort of what is it called? The bits. She had to colour in the bits. So that's what happened. Hey, we've got a French guy in the room. Hello, Sand Lab. Talking about sand, some people like to use sand paper, not sand labs, to make it smoother. But I think it's smooth enough. And actually using pastel, using this kind of very fatty sort of crayons, means that it's quite a flat surface now. So let's get right to it, and let's still yeah, it's a Picasso effect, is it? I thought it was more of a, what's that French guy called, Muka, not Muka, the one with the colors. I like him a lot. I've forgotten his name. Yeah, maybe it's Picasso. I'll take it. It's not a bad compliment. So, our stuff is in here. The strings are here, and let's get started. Mondrian. Yeah, maybe. Braque. I was thinking of Braque, but it's more, isn't Georges Braque more like lines and angles? Yeah, I mean, that's the thing with artists. They do one successful thing, and then it's very loud. Okay, let's do this. Now let's see if I can remember how this works. I can show you up close. Let's have a little look at what's going on. So these things, obviously you don't put them in like this, because this is supposed to be behind. So like this. Wait, they're not little holes already? Let me check my old one. I mean old, it's not that old. And this one was painted after it was all put together. So, yeah, it's like a V shape with the turny turnies just underneath. So this is going to be actually this one or this one. So let's get started. And maybe there's something missing there. I mean, there's really detailed, what's it called when they give you paper? Paperography with this. But for some reason, this is on top. But for some reason, I'm not a big reading how to do things guy. I'm more of a let me figure this out by myself kind of guy. So I made quite a few mistakes with the first one, especially in measuring and stuff. So hopefully this one goes a bit better. But if you do order the kit and you actually read the little booklet, which I moved because I don't like booklets, but they're around here somewhere, then you should be fine. Okay, time to get some screws going around here. Hope it's these little grey ones, and I remember that was really tricky to get them to stand in the thing, because what happens is the holes aren't pre-made. So they tend to not sit in the thing. But let me show you what's happening anyway. We'll just do this together. And maybe somebody in the comments will tell a funny joke.
It's here probably.
To south.
No, that's too far. It's gonna be here. Okay.
Good luck seeing anything, but obviously, if I was well organized and tidy, you know, I would have read whatever they sent with the instrument. Oh no, it was going so well, I had it in. Oh boy. I did read it. It didn't help a lot, says SoundLab. Did it really? Are you sure it was the same one or was it a different brand? Because it's like 10 pages. I don't know why they didn't do like an IKEA thing. I'm going to write to them actually and suggest, you know, they look at how IKEA does it and that they do the same because, I don't know. I think I was going to say who's got the time to read, but actually everybody's got the time to read. It's just, if it's not flashing in front of us, like on Instagram or I guess TikTok that I don't use, then our brains aren't trained really anymore. Yeah. Let's see if this turns. Whoop. Yeah, that'll do. I mean, I'm screwing. Whoop. Yeah, so one side note. Don't screw too hard onto this thing because you don't want to damage it. So that little crack you heard? Yeah, try and avoid that. Okay, so we've got our first squiggly. Yeah, it's squiggling. And then this turns the little dented wheel here, the gear, and then turns this. So we're good to go. Four to go. Ah, why do French like to eat snails? Yeah, good question, Anne. Why do we like to eat snails? I think it's because they're really tasty. I think that's the reason. I don't really have another. Yeah, I think they're just quite tasty. The thing is, I mean, I can understand why you don't want to eat them. But obviously we don't eat them raw, right? We don't eat them. Here, I've added my second one. Let me add the little gray thingy that goes here at the top, and there is the sort of, oh, there's already one. What? How did that happen? Oh, I put them in already. Okay, well, let me finish these. Why the French? I guess if they've dried for a long time, they have to dry for 2 to 3 weeks, snails. And in the sun in the olden days, but now I'm pretty sure they have ventilators and big machines to do that kind of thing. And then we put them back with lots of what we call snail butter. Not batter, butter, B-U-T-T-E-R. And so it's half butter, half snail. And it makes it very soft and flavorful, actually, and with lots of herbs. And there's a special type of herb mix with butter that we use for this kind of thing. And it's quite nice. It's a bit of a delicacy, it's a nice dish. And actually, first ukulele, little parenthesis here in the snail conversation, the garlic and butter, yeah, that is why it sounds nice. Yeah, and SoundLab, do send me a picture of your ukulele on Instagram, I'd love that. I'm Ukulele Road Trips, I've also got a channel called Ben's Uke Tutorials, and I've even got a channel in French called Beno Ukulele on Instagram, so I'm very much there. But don't send it on Ben's Uke Tutorials because I don't know what the password is to that one. I gave it to somebody to to do it for me and haven't been there in a while. Yeah, send it to Ukulele Road Trips or Ben AU Ukulele. Ben O Ukulele. Yeah. Oh, this is not going in. But this is a bit like snails, right? So you have a space, put something in, and then it's going to be delightful. That's the idea. By the way, how do you rate the art, right? I didn't do these lines. The mother of the artist did. I did the lines at the front. And I was a bit concerned that there was too much use of yellow here. But I think that it's an artistic decision to sort of accompany the strings. So that's what you do. You let it go. Okay, let's put both of these in and then we'll be done. Wow, this is exciting. We're almost there, people. Just these screws. Here's some sugar strings. They all pad the nut up there. I'm not sure how much though, but yeah, let's see. Yeah, actually, you know how delicious garlic bread is, right? It's butter and these garlicky flavors. Well, that's what snails taste like, really, to us French people. Except they're a bit more chewy. But they're not slimy, because as I said, all the slime, oh boy, goes out the window, or the shell. Oh boy. I remember struggling with this so much. They don't like fast food. Snails. Yeah, snails are not fast food, that's for sure. Ah, here's a tip. You know what? Do a pre-hole with your screwdriver. Oh, try and have them sort of straight. And then it'll be easier to pop the screw in. Don't know why I didn't think of that last time, but I did spend a lot of time complaining in French, going, oh, this is really difficult. But now, with the pre-holes, we should be good to pre-go. Oh, there you go. So, if you're going to France, and you're in the region where they do snails, you don't need to taste snails if you're in the north, for example. That's really not where you want to be eating those. In the north, it's a bit like Belgium and Dutch food. Probably Anne can vouch for that. Oh boy, struggling again. Okay, well, let's have a change of angles. So the cinematography gets a bit, you know, a bit of variation. Yeah, Bourgogne. Yeah, exactly. Bourgogne. That's what's up, Sand Lab. That's where it's happening, Burgundy. And I wouldn't recommend tasting all the local delicacies, because some are a bit dodgy, like my one, the one from my region, where we make sausages out of pigs' insides. So you just the insides bit, the digestive system. It's not the meat, it's the digestive system of the pig. You cut it up and wrap it in digestive system, and yeah. Yeah, so it's a very popular dish. It's also another word that we use for idiot. So it can either mean idiot or pig's insides wrapped in pig's insides, which is, yeah, not for the faint-hearted, I suppose. If you're in Normandy, you can have fish. That's quite nice, we've got a lot of sea. If you're vegetarian, you can have lots of wonderful apples when it's apple season. And at the moment, we've got apricots here. My local farmer at the market, he's starting with the apricots, raspberries, spinach, all the veggies. Yeah, we've got it going big time here in Normandy. And the cider, of course, that's how we roll. Whoa, lots of cider. Andouille, yeah, that is what it's called. Andouille, yeah. Big hit with the, I don't know, with the grandparents, that one, I suppose. Well, yeah. I've got my reservations, but I suppose it depends what you're used to eating, right? Okay.